Hello everyone, this is Dr. Jagannathan. I am doing my third year post graduation in BGMC Ahmedabad. I am here to present a case of conjoint twins. Most interesting conjoint malformation is a conjoint twin. Conjoint twins are a rare occurrence. They are known as Siamese twins after first Siamese twins exhibited in America in 1829. And these twins were born in Thailand, so they named it Siamese twins. So we present a case report of conjoint twins, and ultrasound and color Doppler techniques were used, which were performed in a Samsung TVX USG machine. And the patient is an 18-year-old primary gebita presented with history of 5 months of amenorrhea to the obstetric department, and she was referred to radiology department for second trimester scan to exclude any fetal anomaly. And we performed USG, and following findings were there. Both fetuses appear to be fused at lower abdomen and pelvis on ventral aspect, and both thoracic cavities appear separate. Both heads were separate, and the process of fusion began at the level of liver. At the level of liver, liver of two twins appears to be fused, but the stomach bowels appear separate, and there is single umbilical cord is seen supplying twins, and three lower limbs could be appreciated, and two of them appear to be deformed with shortened femur and tibia, and there is single bladder bubble. So, on the basis of the findings, the diagnosis of osteopagus conjoint twins was made. Because in most commonly, the lower limb anomalies are associated with osteopagus conjoint twins. And the parents were informed about the malformation and the twins' poor chance of survival. Hence, termination of pregnancy was done. And gross specimen analysis showed single male external genitalia in addition to the aforementioned findings. So, these are the pictures. In this first picture, we can see both heads facing each other with anterior placenta. And in this second picture shows a separate thoracic cavities with separate heart and both spine facing each other. Then here it is at the level of liver where the fusion has occurred. And this is only single, this picture shows single bladder bubble. And this is color Doppler analysis of umbilical cord. These two are the contiguous sections, which shows that both the fetus are supplied by single umbilical cord. And this is a gross specimen after medical termination of pregnancy. There is single umbilical cord, and there is fusion and the pelvis on ventral aspect, and there is single external male genitalia. So, moving on to discussion. Conjoint twins are rare. Exact prevalence is not known. The estimated prevalence is 1 in 50,000 or 1 in 2 lakh. And there is a female predominance of the order of 3:1. The conjoint twinning process occurs when the division of embryonic disc occurs more than 14 days after fertilization. After 14 days of fertilization, there is an incomplete division, which results in conjoint twins. So this incomplete division is more severe when it occurs in the later stage. So later the division, the more severe the effect. So duplicata incompleta is the most severe form of incomplete division, because division is so late and incomplete, and only a few organ systems are duplicated. So when this twin has matured, postnatally, the surgical division becomes impossible, and it poses a great challenge to surgeons. So classification of conjoint twins, it is dependent on the basis of the part used. So when thorax is fused, thoracophagus, in case of abdomen, omphalophagus. In case of sacrum, it is pygophagus, and pelvis, ischiophagus. When skull is used, it is craniophagus, and when face is used, it is cephalophagus. And when both back are fused, it is called rachiphagus. And paraphagus is the fusion of ventrolateral labia. So this is the occurrence. 40%, most of the conjoint twins are thoracophagus, that is 40%. The next comes omphalophagus, then pygophagus, and ischiophagus, which is 6%. So this is the pictorial representation of conjoint twins, and this is thoracophagus, this is omphalophagus, and pygophagus, this is ischiophagus, and craniophagus, paraphagus, that is ventrolateral area fusion, and this is cephalophagus, and this is rachiphagus, that is back fusion of the back. So diagnostic criteria on USG, in the first trimester, there will be bifid appearance of the fetal pole, which is useful to diagnose the conjoint twins. And when the baby matures, we can demonstrate a continuous non-separated external skin contact with conjoint body parts, and body parts of the twin are imaged on the same level and in the same sonar plane. And no change in relative position of the twins to one another, and non-subsequent scan. monochorionic twinning will be there. There is single placental mass and no intertwin membrane. And more than three vessels can be visualized in a single umbilical cord. And there will be associated complex multiple fetal anomalies. So finally, the prognosis. Usually, the prognosis of congenital twins is unfavorable. Approximately 40% cases are stillborn. So worst prognosis concerned with craniophagus and those with a sole cardiac mass, that is thoracophagus. So structural anomalies are frequently found, such as polyhydramnios, cardiac malformation, and omphalosis, and neural tube defects. When congenital twins are diagnosed in person second trimester, usually termination of pregnancy should therefore be recommended due to its poor prognosis. But if the patient presented in late trimester with congenital twins, further initiation such as MRI, fetal MRI is to be planned to accurately define anatomic fusion, vascular anomalies, and other associated abnormalities, which is important for surgical planning and prognostic information, and which will help the pediatric surgeons to plan surgery. Thank you.